Good morning, dear students. Today I will discuss to the introduction to fossil fuel steam station. This is the unit 2 part, and the subject name is power plant engineering. The semester is 7. This is the energy sources. Fuels, it may be of the solid. There is a coal, coke, anthracite, liquid fuel, that is the petroleum derivative. Gas, that is a natural gas, blast furnace gas, that is the categories of the fuel. And depending on the application, different types of the fuels may be used in the power plant. So here there are the three types of the fuel, solid, liquid and the gases. And then move to the energy stored in the water, that is a energy sources of the another kind: nuclear energy, wind energy, solar energy, tidal energy, geothermal energy is the another kind of the energy sources. So nuclear energy, which is the created by the nuclear reactions, wind energy or wind power, it will be created by the wind action and generated through the rotation of the rotor through the action of the winds. Solar energy, it is directly supplied by the sun, tidal power, which is the generated from if the tides are the up and down. Geothermal energy, already discussed in the previous unit, the energy which is the occurs from the earth's surface. This is the fuel, a chemical fuel, that is a substance which releases the heat energy on the combustion. Carbon and hydrogen are the principal combustible element, that is called a fuel. Types of the fuel, that is the three category of the fuel: solid, liquid and the gases. And the type of fuel, it may be of the solid, natural way, and the natural way the fuel may be of the wood, peat, lignite, coal. This is called a solid fuel. And the prepared fuel, that is called a coal, coke, charcoal, anthracite. These are the solid fuel types. Liquid fuel, it will be discussed in the later slides. The petroleum is the liquid fuel, and the prepared fuel, it is called a gasoline or the kerosene. And the gaseous fuel, it will be of the natural gas by the nature, and the prepared fuel, that is a coal gas, coke gas, and the blast furnace gas. Solid fuel, that is a coal, its main component are the carbon, hydrogen and the nitrogen. Sulfur, moisture and the ice passes through the different stages like the peat, lignite, brown coal and the semi-bituminous. That is a coal, bituminous, coal, semi-anthracite, anthracite, these are the coal solid fuels. Properties of the coal: energy content of the heating value, this is the main property, sulfur content, another property, burning characteristic, third properties, and the grindability is the fourth property of the solid fuel. A good coal should have the low ash content and the high calorific value, a small percentage of sulfur, burning capacity should be of good, that is the good coal should have the following properties. Grading of coal, grading is done on the following basis: a grade written as the 5 to 10 centimeter, that is the mini type of the fuel, mini type of the coal. 500 to A8, F24, S1.6, that is another type of the fuel. So depending on the applications, the grading of coal can be categorized in the different ways. It will be of the size. Size may be of the different, or it will be changed. It will be of the mini to micro, and the micro to macro. These are all the types of the fuel will be available in the market, and it will be used, and depending on the conditions. Heating value, depending on the how much amount of the heat liberated from the after the combustion of fuel, it is called a heating value. As contained, there will be chances of AS will be deposited, or AS will be generated after the combustion of fuel. It may be of the solid fuel. Coal fuel, if the coal fuel is a combustion, then there will be chances of AS will be drainage from the outside of the combustion chamber. As softening temperature, this is the temperature where it will be the cool down of the ash to reuse of the ash into the regain form. Sulfur contain, removing of the sulfur, it is a major task about after the combustion. This is the liquid fuel. The petroleum is the natural way, and the heavy oil or the crude oil is refined in the refineries, which gives most important product called the petrol. Composition of the some liquid fuel is as under. The fuel may be of the different types. Liquid fuel, the carbon percentage is varies from the each and every type of the fuel. Hydrogen, sulfur and the ash content may also be varied according to the type of fuel. The categories of the all the fuel, liquid fuel, it will be discussed in the table, and describing the carbon, hydrogen, and the sulfur IS percentage given here. The petrol percentage of petrol having the carbon, hydrogen, and the sulfur percentage are the vary, and the liquid are presented in the table. Benzene, it is also presented. Kerosene, diesel oil, light fuel, and the heavy fuel is also categorized in the all type of the categories: carbon, hydrogen, and the sulfur. So there are a number of the fuel where will be discussed. Important properties of the liquid, that is called specific gravity. Specific gravity, flash point, volatility, as contained, sulfur content, corrosive properties, heating value, specific gravity of the fuel where the fuel may be used at a standard level and normal atmospheric temperature and pressure. Flash point, it is another thing where the categories of the fuel in the basis of the combustion. As contained, sulfur content, it should be of the sulfur content should be low, corrosive properties should be low, heating value should be high, as content should be minimum. Volatility is the of the average value of the fuel, it should be requirement of the liquid fuels. Liquid fuels should have the low as content, high heating value, less corrosive density, less sulfur content. These are the important characteristics or the desirement of the fuel. So gaseous fuel or the different kinds. Gaseous fuel are the different kinds. It is a natural gas by producing of the natural way, and coal gas, coke oven gas, and the blast furnace gas is the another type of the gases which are used in the depends on the application. The natural gas, the main component of the natural gas are the methane and the ethane, that is the CH4 and the C2H6. It has a calorific value nearly 21,000 kilojoule per meter cube. And the natural gas is used alternately or simultaneously with oil or the internal combustion. Coal gas, hydrogen, carbon monoxide, hydrocarbon, that is prepared by the carbonization of the coal. Coke oven gas, it is obtained during the production of the coke by heating the bituminous coal, that is called a coke oven gas. Blast furnace gas, it is produced during the smelting operation if the air is forced through the layers of the coke and the iron arc. These are the blast furnace gases. So all type of the gases where the prepared are used, and it will be depends on the application, it will be used by the different types of the prepared gas. Advantages, what are the advantages of the gases fuel? Cleanliness and the greater control of the combustion and the no problem of the storage. These are the main advantages of the gases fuel used. Much less excess air is required for the complete combustion. More efficiency of the furnace operation, it is the main requirement for the advantage of the gaseous fuel. Composition of the gaseous fuel, that is the hydrogen, carbon monoxide, CH4, methane, C2H4, C2H6, C4H8, CO2, O2, and the nitrogen. These are the composition of the gaseous fuel. Energy stored in the water. The energy stored in the flowing streams of the water contains the mechanical energy. It may exist as the kinetic energy of a moving stream or as a potential energy of the water dam. Water power is quite cheap where the water is available in the abundance. Capital cost of the hydroelectric power plant is higher. Operating cost is low. This is the main fundamental about the energy stored in the water. This is the steam power plant. Using the coal, gas, or the oil, natural fusion to generate steam in boilers, steam generators. Steam is the utilized to drive the turbine, which are coupled to generator to get electricity. This type of the plant may be the contain several other heat saving devices like the water heater. This is the steam power plants. This is the this type of the plant may be contain the several type of the other heating sources devices like the water heater. So steam power plant, this is working on the using of the different types of the fuel. That means fuel is a use of the different type. There will be a increasing of the steam power capacity. This is a thermal power plant. Steam fossil fuel station, it is the first kind of the thermal power plant. A thermal power station, that is the power plant in which the prime mover is steam driven, and the water is heated turned into the steam, and the spins is the steam turbine which drives the electric generator. After this passes through the turbine, the steam is condensed in a condenser. and recycled to where it is heated. And this is also known as the Rankine cycle. The Rankine cycle, in which consists of the number of elements in a thermal power plant, basically 5 units are there installed. Boiler, it will be produced of the steam after the combustion of water, after the combustion of the fuel and the supply of heat by the fuel, combustion of fuel and supply of heat to the water converted into the steam. Steam are used by the nozzle by the changing of the kinetic energy into the pressure energy, changing of the pressure energy into the kinetic energy, and it will be passed through the turbine after followed by the expansion in the nozzle, where the expansion of the steam is taking place in the turbine. And after that, if the turbine expansion is taking place, the expanded steam will be passed through the condenser side, where it will be condensed into the liquid form. And there will be a chances of the, after that condenser unit, it will be of the steam will be converted into the liquid form. And this liquid is recirculated into the boiler side through the feed pump. This is the main theme of the thermal power plant. The greatest variation in the design of thermal power station is due to the different fuel sources. This is the basically diagram of the thermal power plant. Boiler, high pressure turbine, low pressure turbine, generator, all the things are the installed here. Condenser unit, feed water heater, the boiler where the steam is producing, and supplying to the high pressure turbine where the expansion is taking place. The first stage expansion is taking place in the high pressure turbine. After that, it will be passing through the feed water heater. Suppose that if the high pressure, high temperature steam will be passing through the turbine, so some of the steam will be extracted from the high pressure turbine. It will be going into the feed water heater because of the requirement of the boiler. The hot water is required because of the, if the hot water is not supplied, there is a, such a more amount of the heat is required to convert water into the steam form. After that high pressure turbine, the steam will be going into the low pressure turbine, where the further expansion is taking place. Steam expansion is taking place further in the low pressure turbine, is passing through the condenser unit where it is converted into the liquid form. And the low pressure turbine generated the power, which will be generated into the generator, and generator convert the this kinetic energy or mechanical energy into the electrical energy. And after that, condenser unit, the water will be collected at the bottom side, which will be supplied by the feed pump. And through the feed water heater, the water is again supplied to the feed pump 2. And after that, the feed pump 2, the hot water which is supplied to the boiler side, it will be of the compression process. The conversion from the coal to electricity takes place in the 3 stages. The first conversion of the energy takes place in the boiler. The coal is burned into the boiler surface furnace to produce the heat. Carbon in the coal and the oxygen in the air combine to produce the carbon dioxide and the heat. So the stage 2, the second stage is the thermodynamic process. The heat from the combustion of the coal boils water in the boiler to produce the steam. In modern power plant, boiler produces the steam at a high pressure and temperature. The steam is then piped to the turbine. The high pressure steam in pipings and the expand across a number of sets of blades in the turbine. The impulse and the thrust created rotates the turbine. The steam is then condensed to the water and pumped back into the boiler to repeat the cycle. So this is the structure of the thermal power plant, where all the units are describing is here. All the units are describing is here because of the number of the main elements are the here presented. Components of a modern steam power plant. First is the cooling tower, which are already presented in the diagram. 2 is the cooling water pump. 3 is the transmission line. 4 is the unit transformer, also, transformer, that is a 3-phase. 5th is the electric generator, that is also 3-phase. Low pressure turbine, that is already discussed in the previous slide. Boiler feed pump, that is the 7th number. 8th number, that is the condenser unit, where steam will be condensed into the liquid form. 9th number, that is the intermediate pressure turbine, where the pressure will be steam will be reduced through the expansion of the steam taking place. 10th number, that is the steam governor. Governing of the steam is taken by the steam governor valve. 11th number is the high pressure turbine, where the expansion is done in the high manner. And the 12th number is the deteriorator. And 13th feed heater. 14 is a coal conveyor hopper. 15 is the coal. 16 is the pump dry spool mill, fuel mill, 17 is the boiler drum. Eighteen is the air hopper, 19 is the superheater. 20 is the forced draught fan, that is a three phase. 21 is the reheater, 22 is the air intake, 23 is the economizer, 24 is the air preheater, 25 is the precipitator, 26 is the induced draught fan, and 27 is the chimney stack. These are the all the equipments or the all the components of the modern steam power plant which are were used. This is the diagram where the thermal power plant is practically described in the diagram. This is the cooling tower which are here represented for the economical working for the steam generation. So this is the today lecture. Thank you. This is the today lecture.